Law and Home Affairs Minister K. Shanmugam says developments in the Middle East can have a powerful effect on Southeast Asia, given both sides' close links. Speaking before a Middle East Institute lecture by United Arab Emirates' Assistant Cultural Affairs Minister Omar Saif Gobash, he said this includes the Middle East's stance on religion. For example, he said people from this region have traveled to the Middle East to join extremist groups. He cited a book written by Mr. Omar on how young Muslims should navigate the modern world and resist radicalism.
The book's core message, to keep an open and critical mind to meet the challenges of the 21st century, is extremely important and encouraging to us, and something which I hope people in this region, both Muslims and non-Muslims, will understand.
In his lecture, Mr. Omar described how his country tackled extremist, exclusivist ideology. He said the UAE pursued multilateralism, for instance, in the fight against COVID-19. It is now liberalizing policies to attract talent and investment from abroad. Mr. Omar highlighted the peace treaty that the UAE signed with Israel last year to show how it's also fixing previously strained relations with others.
We are a sovereign nation and we have full agency. We decide what is in our interest and we'll act on that. Secondly, we believe in communication, not stonewalling. Refusing to speak to those we disagree with has led to suboptimal outcomes for ourselves and for much of the Arab world. Thirdly, we are able to segregate files in our dealings with other countries. Yes, we disagree on the Palestinian issue, but yes, we can also work together in the economic and technological fields. Fourthly, we are pragmatic, and our primary duty is internal to the UAE.